In today's video, I am going to explain movement of scapula. You know, scapula moves through multi direction. In first section, I'm going to explain basic movements. And on second section, I'm going to explain kind of advanced movement. Let me explain six basic movements in first part. All right, first one is this vector, this direction. This is elevation. It's easy, right? You elevate scapula this way. And what is opposite movement? What is this movement? This is depression. Depression. What kind of muscles do elevation? It's basically superior part of muscle. What is superior part? It's like trapezius. Trapezius and levator scapula. I'm not going to name every single muscles. I want you to understand elevation muscles are kind of above scapula, right? So what is depression muscle? It's basically inferior part of muscles. That's simple. Elevation and depression. Then next movements are this side-to-side movement. This outside movement is abduction. Okay, this is scapular abduction. It is not shoulder abduction. Scapular abduction is you bring scapula outward. This is scapular abduction, but shoulder abduction is this way. This is side raising movement. This is shoulder abduction. Differentiating these movements are very important. Anyway, scapular abduction. What about this movement? This is scapular adduction. Scapular adduction. Shoulder adduction is this way. Outside, abduction. Inside, adduction. So what kind of muscles do adduction? It's basically the inside muscles such as rhomboid. Rhomboid and trapezius. Rhomboid and trapezius. How about abduction? It's a little bit hard to visualize. One example is there is muscle on anterior part of scapula. That is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior. Serratus anterior contracts this way. That's for outside. Then this outside contraction brings scapula to abduction. All right, I explained four movements. Elevation, depression, scapular abduction, and scapular adduction. Now let's go to other two basic movements. Next two movements are this way and this way. It's kind of rotational movement. This way rotation is upward rotation. And this way kind of rotation is downward rotation. So upward rotation is scapula rotates towards shoulder joints. Downward rotation is rotation towards kind of thoracic spines. Now these two movements are essential for shoulder movement. If scapula does not move, your shoulder does not move. Thus, movement of scapula is frigging important for upper extremity. Very important. These six movements are basic movements. Elevation, depression, abduction and adduction. Upward rotation, downward rotation. Let me explain kind of advanced movements. Alright, this is superior view. You are looking scapula and ribcage from superior view. Next two movements are also rotational movement. They are internal rotation and external rotation. Wait a minute, is internal rotation and external rotation for shoulder movement? Yes, that is true. Shoulder does rotation and also scapula does rotation. And what kind of movement is scapula internal rotation? That is this way. This is internal rotation. And the other way, This way is external rotation. It's a little bit confusing. What is good tip to memorize internal rotation and external rotation? Vector of internal rotation is same way as shoulder rotation. Let's say this is shoulder internal rotation. Rotation for inward. So it's like scapular internal rotation. Scapular internal rotation is this way. See, that is same vector, same direction. On the other hand, shoulder external rotation is this way. Thus, scapular external rotation is also this way. Do you see this relationship? Thus, direction of rotation of scapular and shoulder are same way. That's easy to memorize, right? So, next two movements. This is profile view of scapula. Next two movements are this way. This kind of rotational movement again. This way is anterior tilt. Anterior tilt. The other way is posterior tilt. You know anterior tilt and posterior tilt, right? They are the same movement in pelvis. Pelvis also has anterior tilt and posterior tilt. Yet, scapula also does same thing. I explained four kind of advanced movements. Internal rotation, external rotation, and anterior tilt and posterior tilt. Now, let me explain why you should study anatomy in three-dimensional way. Okay, this is posterior view. Again, this is most famous scapular picture in anatomy, right? However, it looks very flat. It looks very two-dimensional picture, don't you think? However, human body is not two-dimensional. It's three-dimensional, right? This is superior view. See, there is kind of angle in scapula. If you see scapula from posterior view, it looks completely flat. But is it not flat? This posterior view makes looking like scapula flat, but it's not flat. Thus, when you do scapular abduction, in this picture it looks like just the two-dimensional movement, right? However, it is not. Scapula should move like diagonal scapular abduction. So it's like scapular adduction. It's like this movement. It's not completely the horizontal movement. Plus, ribcage is here. Ribcage is round shape. Plus, scapula has a kind of a concave surface. They are kind of fitting like this. So this is oval shape, right? So when you do scapular abduction, there is somehow more movement. Maybe there is internal rotation. You just cannot bring scapula just linear way. It should move in a rotational way. So maybe internal rotation is included with scapular abduction. Well, that makes sense. So you can say same thing for scapular elevation and depression. You just cannot move elevation completely vertical, nor like depression. When you bring scapula upward, somehow you should move scapula a little bit anterior tilt. Or for depression, maybe you should move scapula for a little bit posterior tilt. Scapula is three-dimensional structure. Thus, there's no way that you can do pure one movement. Some other movements must be included somehow. Maybe 1%, maybe 0.1%. You know what I'm talking about? Scapula is not flat structure. It is three-dimensional structure. So many movements are included in one single movement. That is why I recommend you to study anatomy in three-dimensional way. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.